think of Transylvania, I think of like Dracula.
Vampires.
Dracula. A film I've seen.
Yeah. Vampires.
Frankenstein and Dracula.
What? Transylvania, vampires, Dracula.
I think about vampires and shit.
Vampires and werewolves.
Vampires.
Dracula.
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 Why?
That's all I know about Transylvania.
It's like a spooky place.
Transylvania, the land beyond the forest. To many, it is the land of Dracula, but in reality, it is a land of great history and natural beauty. But what is really Transylvania? Transylvania is a region of Romania in Eastern Europe, and it is approximately the size of West Virginia. The population of Transylvania consists of Romanians, Hungarians, Gypsies, and Germans. Transylvania has been a source of friction between Hungary and Romania, both claiming that it was their land first. Few people realize that Hungarians living in Transylvania are the largest minority in Europe. One outstanding figure in the history of Transylvania is Vlad Țepeș, also called Dracula. In Romanian, Dracul means devil, as well as dragon. He was born in 1431 in Transylvania and died in 1476. Vlad became ruler of Wallachia, the region south of Transylvania. In those days, this was a lawless region, was full of beggars, thieves, and bandits, whom Vlad got rid of in a very short time. But Vlad also developed a reputation of brutality among his enemies. His methods of law enforcement was simple. All crimes were punished by death, and his favorite means of doing it was impalement. The victims were impaled on a sharp wooden stake, and their agony could take hours. However, since Bram Stoker's novel Dracula, one of the greatest horror stories in English literature, the name Transylvania has acquired something of a mythical aura in the imagination of the outside world. People in Eastern Europe are not as aware of Dracula as the Westerners are. Castle Bran is situated in the surroundings of Brasov, the second biggest city in Romania, on a hill. Built in 1377, the castle housed princes, kings, and queens through the centuries and guarded a commercial route between Wallachia and Transylvania. However, Count Dracula has nothing to do with this place. Castle Bran is simply an invention. Tradition plays an important role in people's lives. Carried on from generations to generations, tradition has not really changed since the Middle Ages. The region of Transylvania is famous for its wood carving and other handmade goods. Folklore is strongly present in the literature, architecture, dances, and even in classical music. In several parts of the area, you feel like you're back in time. Transylvania is rich in natural resources like methanol gas and soil deposits, and they play a significant role in the natural healing process of the population. Enormous salt mines where people with respiratory problems would spend hours. Mineral lakes. And fountains where one does not have to pay for the healthy sparkling water. The highland of Transylvania is surrounded by the Carpathian Mountains like a crown. The Carpathians are the continuations of the Eastern Alps, from which they are separated by the Danube Valley. The Carpathians form an arc of 1500 kilometers long. And reach a height of 2,500 meters, about 8,000 feet. As these isolated regions are more and more reached by progress, traditional villages change and modernize. While 40 years of hardship under communism held back Romania to a great extent from development, Transylvania, on the other hand, was still able to retain its identity and culture. While the past still plays a great part in people's everyday lives, provincial towns and big cities have flourished. Actually, one trip to this region is enough to make one sure that Transylvania is more than a mysterious place in a fiction book.